When we look at PFAS contamination in New Hampshire, we've always tracked it to a source. Well, this study doesn't show that there's one specific source.
State Representative Rosemary Rung says she was a little concerned to see that PFAS had showed up in random shallow soil sample testing, away from the areas usually home to the potentially harmful chemical. Rung says one of the things she learned from the study is that the state should look outside of point sources, usually fire suppressants and industrial contamination, like at Pease Air Force Base and St. Gobain, and start looking up at air emissions.
Most of the wells that do exceed our standards are located in communities where we believe there's been impacts from air emissions from PFAS facilities that use PFAS.
Jeffrey Martz with DES says of the 10,000 wells they have tested, the PFAS levels were under their standard. And just because PFAS was found across the state doesn't mean your water is contaminated. DES partnered with the USGS to get a better understanding of New Hampshire's soil back in 2019 to gather essential data on the PFAS impact. This information will be used as the DES works to establish new soil remediation standards in the state that protect groundwater.
This information is really informing DES on what those specific maximum contaminant levels should be.
And Representative Rung says she hopes that federal partners step in and make stricter regulations on PFAS. Live in Portsmouth, Kelly O'Brien, WMUR News 9.